So last topic of this requirements engineering is the final is management. So in this requirements management, the manager will concludes the information which is collected for the requirement, how will be proceed for further. So the manager will get some clarity, what is the schedule, in how much of time it will be completed, what is the cost will be there, how many number of employees or the members or the how many developers, how many the staff is required to develop this project. That all sort of stuff will be come to conclusion in the requirement management. So in the requirement management, we have two different topics. One is the requirement management planning. Another is the requirements change management. Now, when you coming to the planning, before going to the planning, let me see how the evaluation of this requirement will be done. The evaluation will be goes on. So requirements for large software system are always changing. This is a everyone has to accept this point, because for large systems always the changes will come. Now one reason for this is that these systems are usually developed to address wicked problems. Wicked problems in the sense can't be a completely defined, because they started the project without having any plan, without collecting of all the backend literature. They simply start working on them. So such type of problems are called as wicked problems. So these wicked problems can't be completely defined. So because of not completely defined, more changes. Always there is a chances for go for change. If you see the figure, initially you are understand of problem, and based on the understanding of the problem, you collected initial requirements. As time goes on, if you see the x-axis, as the time goes on, there is variation in the understanding of the problem. Initially you understand like this, after some sort of time period, you are have changed the way of understanding of problem. So initially, because I thought so like this, but it is not like this, I thought in a wrong way, so I need to change my understanding of problem. If you change of understanding problem, then there is a change in the requirement as well. So there is a problem between this one. Because of this, between this, initially understanding is varying. Later on, the understanding will vary. Because of that, the requirement, whatever you are initially talking about there, it will be changed again for a later time. So to fulfill this gap, definitely we require planning. That is the first topic it is talking about, requirements planning. So before going to for the requirement management planning, first of all, understand what is the definition of requirements management. So requirement management is the process of understanding and controlling the changes to system requirement. That is a major role between the manager. Because if you are keep on changing the requirements, definitely the cost, the time of the completion project will vary. So the job of the manager is, it has to understand the process as well as controlling the changes of system. If you not control, definitely there is a problem in the cost as well as in the schedule. And keep track of individual requirements and maintain the links between the dependent requirements so that you can assess the impacts of requirement changes. Because maybe for some modules, the same requirements or some partial requirements of module one. Say for example, if a project having the three modules, whatever the requirements you are using in the module one, some partial requirements of module one can be used for module two. When you can know that, if you are keep tracking of individual requirements and if you are maintaining the links between the dependent requirements, definitely as a manager, you will be know that you can please use some of the requirements which is available in module one for module two, which are partially of module two requirement can use for module three. So you can easily map, easily can say when you keep track of all the requirements. And you can establish a formal process, because formal process, if you are not maintaining, formal process means what? Conducting the review meetings, establish some the connections of in the different forms of the formal technical reviews, FTRs, to know what make the proposal changes. Means when you are for making change of in the proposal, definitely we had to be make only with the help of review meetings. So, and linking these system requirements with the help of this formal process meetings only, we can do it. So once you can establish this formal process means review meetings, like we have seen in the Scrum model. In the Scrum model, every day, 15 minutes, there is a meeting. Before going to start the day, there will be 15 minutes of meeting. What they conclude in the meeting, what actually the completion of project up to yesterday, and what we need to do today. That will be make sure in the formal meeting. And this formal process will make you the management that start as soon as the draft version of the requirement document is available. So if you have a version of document available, immediately conduct a formal process, formal meeting, and ask them whether really we are going in a wrong way or in a right way, really whether going in the right way or not. So if you are with the help of draft version, if you conduct a formal process, definitely we can make some connection tracking over there, so that we can control the changes to the system, right? And when you coming to the first topic of this is planning. So planning is the first stage in the requirement management process. This is the first stage, planning. So without planning, it is very difficult to control the changes, right? So in this planning, what you need to plan is, first is we need to identify the requirements. First, we need to do the identification of requirements. Second, we had to be make sure the change management process. Change management process will assess you the impact and the cost of changes, because the change management process will tell you if any set of activities will change or any changes will be done, what's the impact of the process of the project development and what's the impact on the cost. Will be defined in this change management process. The third in the planning is traceability policy, because we need to be traced. Just now I had discussed, if you are making keep track of each requirement or between the requirements, then definitely there is a more chance to control the changes. And we need to be use in the planning the tools. What is the purpose of maintaining these tools is to maintain the documentation of all sort of requirement. Because when we have know the total detailed information of a particular requirement, then only we can know that whether this requirement can be applicable to module 2 or module 3 or not. Because without knowing the knowledge of that requirement, we can't justify, we can't map to the other modules, we can't map to the other fulfillment of the task. So to maintain that large amount of information, we require tools as well. So the tools going to be using, the software tools, in the planning phase is for the purpose of the storing, for the purpose of requirement storage, for the purpose of change management, for the purpose of traceability management. We have different types of the open source as well as paid tools are available for storing of your requirements. For changing management, we can have like Gantt charts or any other sort of things we can do it, which can show you clearly where the changes appear. If change is done, what type of impacts will be done it. And as well as traceability management. So easily we can trace with some sort of tools. Like how we can be trace our activities. Like we have a reminders, or like we have some blocks, or we can have some bookmarks. In the bookmarks or reminder, what is the purpose of that? To make a traceability of your daily activities. Like we have some sort of tools, software tools are available for storage of the requirement, for tracking and tracing of the changes in the software. If you see one small figure representation, if the requirement identification, like 1.1, 1.2, 1.3 and so on, these are the requirement identification numbers, where D and R indicates, D indicates the design traceability, R indicates requirement traceability. Any changes in between this requirement or this requirement, any requirement traceability is there or not, we can map it. Any design traceability is there or not, how much it is any change or how much the design has completed, we can maintain is one of the traceability matrix. So in this matrix, it shows clearly from requirement to requirement or within the requirements, how the traceability will be done between the design to design, design to requirement, requirement to design. How the traceability will be done. So this example of this figure shows that the traceability matrix between requirement as well as design things. The second subtopic in this requirement management is requirement change management. So in the change management, first of all, you are going to be identify the problem initially. And once you identify, you analyze the problem and check for any change of specification. If it is there, apply the change analysis and check out whether the cost is fulfilled or not and implement the change and release the revised requirement, right? So once you identify the problem, you need to first of all analyze the actual problem, then see the possibilities of any change specification is there or not and analyze that changes and check whether any impact on the cost or not. If it is satisfied, implement the change, release the second version of the problem, second solution for the problem. So all that phases, all the stages like problem analysis and change specification will identify the requirements problem, sometimes with a specific change proposal. Change analysis and cost impacts on the traceability information, that is normal general knowledge, and also the cost. And once it is done, the change implementation will be done it with the necessary changes in the not only in the requirement documentation, but also in the system design as well as in the implementation. Because changing of one thing is not belongs to only one phase, not only belongs to communication, only belongs to planning. It belongs to the all phases in the design, in the implementation, in the deployment, everything. It will be changed, will be done. Right? So these are the major two subheadings under the requirement management. One is requirement management planning, another is requirement change management, right? So that's about the requirements management.